When Dodge took us to a hangar in Washington, D.C., and offered the keys to any of its fresh and you, we could have taken the raucous new 707 HP first. But we purposely started the day in the SRT 392, somewhat afraid that we might never again be satisfied with its 485 horsepower after driving the world's most powerful production sedan. We needn't have worried. It turns out that the Hellcat leaves a lot of room for fun under its long shadow, the first indication of which came when we brought to life the 392's naturally aspirated 6.4-liter Hemi and its delicious rumble echoed through the building. No car that sounds this good can be all that bad. Right. Within a mile, we were laughing hysterically, drunk on torque some 475 pounds FT of the stuff and bruising past less powerful cars, which was pretty much everything that hadn't been Hellcatted. We also wondered aloud if our licenses would survive the trip to Summit Point Motorsports Park in West Virginia, at which point we'd get to drive on the track. Eventually, we stopped terrorizing locals, started behaving like adults, and took inventory of the experience. Steering tactility, good, road feel, enough to communicate the surface texture, and the overly harsh default ride quality we noted in the old SRT 392s was conspicuous by its absence. Fiddling with the SRT performance pages functions on the center stack screen allowed us to add weight to the steering, which was good for self-centering and muscle building but not much else. We also dialed up the firmness of the Bilstein shocks. The sport mode provides a little better connection to the road, but the track mode is rather too stiff for the street. Powertrain behavior is also adjustable. It ranges from perfectly benign in